I'm the only person that does this ball. I lost in the Walmart and I did it.
Thank you. You may be seated. I am pleased to introduce our senior class president, Ms. Shayla Woods.
Additionally, I would like to recognize school board members, Reverend Haywood and Ms. Tanya Bossen, as well as our central office staff who are in our distinguished guest section. Please stand and be recognized. Graduation candidates and guests, it has been an honor to lead our school and to work with our outstanding and dedicated staff. I have loved all of it. For you candidates, on behalf of the faculty and staff of Norview High School, it gives me great pleasure to congratulate you on this graduation accomplishment. May you all have bright futures, become tremendously successful, and lead our next generation with courage and humility. Good luck, and from us, may you always prosper. Thank you.
Good afternoon, school board members, Dr. Boone, administrators, distinguished guests, faculty and staff, family and friends, and all of my fellow classmates in the class of 2017. My name is Keyshawn Wilson, and it is my pleasure to introduce our next student speaker in the class of 2017 salutatorian, a friend of mine, Helen Decker. Helen is a creative, hardworking, and clever member of the class of 2017. She spent 4 years at Norview in the Leadership Center for the Sciences and Engineering, has served as the drive team coach for the Norview Robotics team, and has attended North Star for all 4 years. Helen has a passion for science and has been recognized as a National Merit Scholar, as an AP Scholar of Distinction, and she was awarded the Virginia Pilot's Scholastic Achievement Award. To date, Helen has earned in excess of $309,000 in scholarships and has selected to attend Virginia Tech in the fall. Please join me in welcoming my friend Helen Decker.
Good afternoon, school board members, Dr. Boone, administrators, distinguished guests, faculty and staff, family and friends, and hopefully unsurprisingly, the class of 2017. As I began preparing the speech, I had a bit of trouble finding my name. I wasn't sure what exactly should go into a salutatory speech. So I did what probably everyone else in this room would have done. I Googled it. In the classroom, we call that research. The info I found contained a lot of cliches about how you should always believe in yourself and follow your dreams, but I'm sure you've heard all of that before. Then, in the midst of my search, I found something kind of fun. A list of famous salutatorians. First on the list was former First Lady Michelle Obama. Then singing phenomenons John Legend and Carrie Underwood. Actor John Wayne, Good Morning America's Robin Roberts, and two-time NBA champion Norris Cole, to name a few. The list was intriguing, but at the same time, unsettling. I'd like to think that I can write a decent research report in just one weekend, but had a nationwide effort to improve the health of American children, write and record hit songs, those are some big shoes to share shoelaces with. Seeing that list of accomplished people, I wondered, am I worthy to join the salutatorian club? And that got me thinking, how often do we do that to ourselves? Downplay our accomplishments by comparing ourselves to others. How often do we lose steam after getting a bad grade on a test or feel defeated when we miss a basketball shot, ignoring all the high marks and three-pointers we've gotten in the past? It can be easy to forget that you can bake a killer cake or that you give your teachers and peers a run for their money in a game of Kahoot when your focus is on what the other people are doing. Those famous people I just named weren't famous right out of high school. They had a long road ahead of them, as do we. Graduation may be the end of high school, but it is also the beginning of the rest of our lives. That's my obligatory graduation speech cliche, by the way. There were people, parents, teachers, friends, who supported them along the way. They made choices, one at a time, that built upon each other until they became the successes that we recognize them as today. I wouldn't be surprised if Michelle Obama had great teachers, like Mrs. Lockett, who once dropped a homework assignment off at my house when I had been out sick for a week in order to make sure that I didn't get too far behind. Maybe Robin Roberts had a mentor as wise as Miss Arroyo. Right there. Who not only taught us how to give speeches in front of inhumanely large groups of people, but also forced us to self-reflect and learn about ourselves. No doubt John Legend's high school principal cared as passionately about their teachers and students as our Dr. Staley does. It's possible that Carrie Underwood met some amazing friends in high school and lost a bet in physics class and had to mention the names of two friends, maybe named CJ and Cody, in her salutatory speech. My point is, we all have humble beginnings, and none of us have reached this point on our own. Today, as we leave here, we will continue to make choices. Some of us will go to college, join the military, start jobs, and eventually families. And we will find new mentors, bosses, friends, who will inspire So my last bit of advice, because who doesn't want a life advice from a teen, 18-year-old, you know, is don't pay attention to the rankings, the list, or the person next to you. Just be you. Because as Oscar Wilde once said, be yourself. Everyone else is already taken. Norview Class of 2017, it's been an honor. Thank you.
Distinguished guests, faculty and staff, family and friends, and all of my fellow classmates in the class of 2017. My name is Zachary Morris, and it is my honor to introduce our next student speaker in the class of 2017 valedictorian, my friend, Alyssa Sawhurst. Alyssa is a strong, focused member of the class of 2017. Alyssa is a very active member of Kingdom Life Ministries, playing keys and singing with the worship team. As a sophomore, she served on a missions team to Colombia, South America, working with children in orphanages. Her schedule was filled with AP courses, and she was named an AP Scholar of Distinction. During her 4 years at Norview, Alyssa has been a dedicated student leader, serving as Secretary of the National Honor Society and on the Scholastic Bowl team. In the fall, she will travel to Tennessee to attend Lee University with a full scholarship in their honors program. Please join me in welcoming my friend, Alyssa Selvis.
Really matters is how you think about and treat others. I stand before you as the valedictorian not simply because I'm a nerd, but because I value hard work and doing the best that I can. And my relationship with God is not one solitary part of me. It is the foundation of my identity. Those are the things that really make up me. When I think about who I am at my core, that's what comes to mind. Your supposed identity can be influenced by things entirely out of your control. You may be the child of immigrants and face certain prejudices and stereotypes in American schooling and society because of that. Maybe you had to learn English during high school, and your accent influencing the language impacts how people see and treat you. Maybe you grew up in a not-so-great neighborhood, and people scoff at your dreams, deeming them unattainable for someone like you. Or maybe one part of your personality is all people focus on, rather than the whole picture. You might be known as the goofy jock when you're also smart and considerate and a leader. I hope you walk out of this room today knowing that who you are does not depend on these things. Ultimately, your identity is up to you. And whether you had a whole network of people supporting you, or you were even discouraged from achieving your goals, we have all made a great accomplishment in being able to walk across this stage. So let's set a goal for ourselves. Try to figure out the basics of who we are as individuals, what we believe, how we feel about life and more controversial issues. Because if we don't know, others will decide for us. When you have a good understanding of your identity, you are better able to live the life that you want.
I'm sorry.
A life in which you do what you enjoy and uphold what matters most to you. But when others have the final say, you end up not being you. You end up living a life you never actually wanted. In the words of Judy Garland, always be a first-rate version of yourself instead of a second-rate version of somebody else. And in order to truly be ourselves, we need to know who we are. Now, I'm not saying you can sit down one day and figure out absolutely everything there is to know about you. We are, after all, ever-changing beings. Maybe you have a good understanding of who you are, or maybe you have no clue. But having a general roadmap of your core principles gives you direction for whatever path you've chosen. I believe each of us was made for a purpose that only we can fulfill. And knowing our identities allows us to carry out these tasks. Class of 2017, be confident in who you are. Discover your roadmap and begin your journey. Thank you. Wow.